All right, folks. Welcome to bringing you another. Sorry, that's my old channel's name. The Celtic Nerd here. Bring you another Tiny Tina's Wonderlands game footage. Sadly, I made some errors. I figured I might as well try and play as much as I can, because one of the things I like about my channel is, well, for the most part, you guys get to see my honest reactions to things, or well, you get to hear my honest things. Like, most of the time when I'm experiencing something, you guys are also getting the chance to experience it with me, unless you guys already played the game, then otherwise. I'm just gonna pick up my controller. I've also done some rearranging. For one, I moved my PC tower from this side of my desk to the other side, because the other side has a lot more support, and I feel like I'm less worried about my PC, you know, my desk caving in a little way. And also, it meant that the monitor for my PC is actually next to my PC. Because the reason why I kept looking over here, as I was, even though my camera was, you know, pointing at this angle, because you guys can probably see I'm at a different angle, was because I was watching this my Xbox, you know. So I'm looking in this. I'm looking in where I am right now. I just moved the camera when I was playing my Xbox, because even though my Xbox is on this side, it's on my right. I had the monitor connected to it on my left. So now I decided to put my everything relating to the Xbox is on the right. Everything related to my PC. Okay, it looks like we lost the webcam. Give me a sec, folks. I have no idea why that deactivated. There we go, we're back. I have no idea why my webcam deactivated. But yeah, I'm also just back from swimming. So, I played a little bit more of Tiny Tina's, and there was some stuff there that I wish you guys saw my reaction to. So, that's why I settled on redoing this. We're going to remake my character. And for funsies, we're actually going to up the difficulty to intense. I did check. Alright, now why is that not showing you guys?
There is a world beyond the borderlands. A world forged by wonder and ruled by fate. The battle between these powers has raged since the beginning. Evil and good. Villains and heroes. A vicious cycle, endlessly repeated. Wonder is the power of a cruel, unpredictable god. But fate. There's one alone who can wield fate. One alone whose story is in their own hands. The Fate Maker. That's you. Heavy, right? Fate Maker. Big responsibility. Honestly, I wouldn't even blame you if you just laid down in a puddle and gave up. But if not, if you try and prove yourself as Fate Maker, then heed the warning I give all heroes. Together you fight. Together you shall fall.
Said, we're the heroes. I am Valentine, gallant adventurer. The scary stabby one is Fred.
What about that one?
That's the newbie. It's their first adventure.
Oh, come on. Their figure isn't even fully painted.
Enough talk. We're here to stop you from taking the soul energy.
Who absorb all of the soul energy. I'm invincible!
Oh, man. Sorry, newbie. You missed the soul energy.
Castles will burn. Babies will cry. More than usual. My skeleton army.
Alright, so we're actually going to skip that. I figured we've already, seen a good bit of it, so. So we're gonna remake the Graveborn. Let's go a little smaller.
What happened?
Oh, yeah. I definitely made the right choice. How's this? That was... I'm at a loss for words at my beauty. Now...
This for funsies.
Oh, yeah. I definitely made the right choice.
Oh, wow.
Now that is a look!
Now, I don't know if it's me or anything, but like, it definitely seems everything is, how should I put it? Everything seems to be well together. Like, I upped the quality of the stream that I do towards my Xbox and my PC. So I think that's why it's probably coming in a lot clearer. I think I already did it that way, so it's... We're just remaking my original character. There we go, get to the point. Is there no facial hair that I picked? Also, I find it funny that it's facial hair and masks, and yet there is no masks listed. So yeah, the quality of the stream has definitely gone up. And also there's like nanosecond lag on everything, which I am really glad about. Right. Where's the eye? There we go, pupils. There we go, evil eyes, and where's the auburn? Oh, sorry, amber. Alright. Ooh, exiled. Now I'm going to look over here to get a bit more of a better look at things, because like with the switch of the monitors, I put my really good quality monitor, which is smaller, on the PC side, and my bigger one is on this side. Oh yeah, and the special brands for them. So we're just going to go to Cloudbringer for there. Not gonna bother with any tattoos. No claw. Oh, that's patterns. Boiled black leather, and then we went with red. There we go. See, everything seems smaller because I actually managed to get OBS to work the way I want it to work. What's this? I have no idea what that is. I like, what is that? Slider overdrive, like. Alright, we're gonna pick failed monk just for the bonuses to int and wisdom. And then we're gonna put all our points into these. You know, a part of me is really thinking of actually just pumping it all into Graveborn. Sorry, into Constitution. That's me. That way I only have 10 points to have to put back into Con, and then we're good to go. Also, it means that, like, I'm taking less of an issue early game with for the health hit. Oh, wrong thing. Oh, I had a player name. There you go. I did not see. I did not see the thing there. What the hell? Where's my keyboard? There you go. X twice. Okay, there was a bit of lag there. One thing I am really looking forward to when I get my own place is, one, I plan to get like a really good internet deal. I don't know if I'm going to be able to fully keep it. I have plans. Can I skip this bit?
Time's up.
Nope.
Okay. Valentine, you've just drawn your own face over the character sheet.
It said, "Draw your hero." And I'm my own hero.
Okay. And Fret, it says your starter sword does murder 1,000 damage?
My bad, I left off a zero.
Okay, no plan! Fret and Valentine can't be trusted with pencils, let alone dice. So it is up to you, newbie. You are the Fate Maker. And these fools shall be thine advisors, I guess.
Fine. I advise that you better be a badass. We're here to slay evil and get gold.
I know you see me as a role model. Follow my lead and you'll be a great Fate Maker.
Alright, one last thing. Bunkers and Badasses is a role-playing game, baby. That means you do not break character voice. Kapiski? Break me off a piece of that.
I've honed my skills over a lifetime of mischief. It's time I take on a real challenge.
Tasty! Now, prepare to enter a world of fantasy!
I don't see anything.
You gotta imagine it, Knucklehead.
Just close your eyes and wonder. You have arrived in the Snoring Valley, an unassuming and peaceful corner of the kingdom.
Alright guys, we're just going to try and speed through this as much as we can, because as I said, I've already, sorry, in the previous video we already covered about an hour.
What I'm hearing is, we get to whoop his ass.
Fridge is out. If I paid taxes, this would hurt me.
You recognize one of the Queen's waystones. It seems to call to you. Queen's magic enters you through the stone, granting you the power of a fallen tree bars your path. What you gonna do about it, huh?
I cast Identify Tree.
It's a species called Jumbus tutorialis, and weirdly, it only grows in this one bone. Ahead, the glint of edged steel beckons you forward.
Still sharp? Things I could chop with this. Not heads, don't worry.
I'm a good
actor. Though the magical hoofprints continue through the cave, the rocky ceiling dips low to the ground.
A true Fate Maker knows when to stand tall and when to crouch.
Yeah, work them sweet glutes. And if you get a running start and crouch, you'll slide around like a cool action hero. Another waystone guides your path, but reaching it will be in going for a pack of nasty pinchy crabs.
Yeah! Combat! Kill them all!
Pinchy! There's no Pinchy!
I'm just gonna look over at my actual Xbox thing.
That one's mine! Don't touch the loot!
You have defeated the crabs! Luckily, they were carrying their life savings. For some reason, all yours now!
Okay.
I think we killed everything down here. Climb up there!
There was a bit of the lag moment, which is why I decided to look. But no, like, again, I'm really glad that the quality is a lot better. And we're just going to recalibrate the display for this screen. See, like, let's see. So I may, as you saw, the dark, now it looks amazing on this monitor right now. It does. It does not look as amazing on that. I think my smaller one is.
That's right. The queen has ruled the Wonderlands. However, the humble player, like you, Bing Bongs, she has foreseen your arrival and left a powerful weapon for you. The weapon.
So yeah, this is one of the main reasons why I wanted to swap the monitors for a while, because this one is just really better. So it would result in a better stream.
You're in Tina's fantasy, baby! Village nestled in the bodacious bosom of the valley. But beyond it, a dark and ancient.
You will never reach the darkness.
Get him out, Ambers!
Go break some bones, fake maker!
Don't join in losing to the best.
But okay, so like right now, like the shadows look so much better compared to what I was looking at earlier. Or sorry, what I was looking at on that monitor. But what was I gonna say? One of the things I'm really enjoying about this game so far, like again, like you guys will definitely see it as we get further in, like is.
Shield above your health.
Just wait until she stops talking. Okay. One of the things I'm enjoying is the fact that like Fret is clearly the murder hobo, which is a term in D&D, like, you know, when players or player are more focused on combat and like their solution to everything is just violence and getting
loot. A rock slide bars your way to the village.
We're ruined. All is lost!
Very heroic. Tina, can we blow up the rocks?
Sorry, it's impossible. Without explosives!
lost hope.
Ahead, you hear the roar of raging fire and the clackety-clackety of bones!
We're here to save...
Ooh, the village is already ransacked and crawling with skilly men.
We're here to avenge the village!
Well, yeah. Fret is clearly the murder hobo, the person who only cares about combat and loot. But then we get the other spectrum, Valentine, which is, you know, the role player. Now, neither one is the right way to play. Yeah, obviously. It depends on your group and the DM. Ooh, you like me sights? Or well, slighted blades. Like that could be, that's very much, a murder hobo attitude. Now, as I said in previous videos and whatnot, like, I have a controller's not the best. I needed to buy a new one.
As much as it kills me to refuse payment, I'm afraid I'm on an urgent quest to prevent the return of the Dragon Lord.
You're a fate maker. I'm
just gonna mark some stuff to be sold. Social, go to meal. There we go. Okay, so that bug is still happening.
Bro, the tomb is in the crypt below Castle Herathas.
Like, it says we. Oh, there we go. It's actually gone through. Thank God. The Skullcracker being a spell. Now, because I'm low level, that's why they're coming up as low.
Mystery before his minions find it.
The tomb is inside a crypt. The perfect hiding place.
May the Queen's favor see your noble brother.
So what the hell does that do? I hate you two. Plus 20% spell damage. Minus 10%. Spell cone, soft cast around the arm. I have no idea what it does, but I'm assuming that thing shoots.
My peasant is killing me.
Time for a spell.
You're seriously gonna summon me and waste my time.
Locked his butt away in a dusty tomb for a few hundred years.
Look, you've been a cranky boy.
think I know what the legendary thing about this platform is. It will spawn like a bat. There's a chance for every shot will spawn a bat, which will then attack a target.
You're seriously going to kill me and waste my time?
Dare!
Gun, you can switch between them. Keeps combat spicy. A jambalaya!
So, Tina, maybe after this quest, I could be the bunker master. I've been working on a campaign. It's got orcs and kissing.
Tina don't play no more, okay? But it's all good. I got megatons of testicles simmering up in my brain sauce, baby.
This whole thing is really below. On the balance. Ready to cost.
I'll do all my exploring later.
The tomb crypt. There's got to be an entrance around here somewhere.
The bone dry air of the crypt whips past you as you hurtle down into the depths beneath the castle. It smells of old stone. Within your soul, it asks a question. Who are you?
try and get a bit more use out of this.
The villain in the first quest. Still, you're stronger than the ones she sent before. I wonder. We'll meet again, Fatemaker. But for now, I have to go pay an old shiny friend a visit. See you around the neighborhood.
Damn it, he got away. We gotta track him down. I want that big bad boss down to loot.
The Fatemaker's journey begins, as so many do, with a heart full of fire and dreams of dragons and magic. It will end only one way, with the ultimate defeat of all evil.
Despite your heroic efforts, the Dragon Lord has escaped!
Wait a minute. Did you hear what he said? Shiny? Friend? Neighborhood? I know where he's headed. He's after Queen Buttstallion!
Warn Queen Buttstallion of the Dragon Lord's escape. You must travel far across the Wonderland. Capital City of Brightwolf.
Oh yeah, I forgot about my terrible stats. We only need to invest 9 more points. 8 more points now into Khan, and then we're done. And then we can focus on some of the other important stats. Luckily enough, like, as long as I can get a good amount of dark magic weapons, I should be able to compensate for the fact that my class is all about using up my health. For power, I'm a big fan of the AoE attack, but the only problem is it's like it's great against mobs, but then you
built you guys this big overworld on the table. Just move your miniature wherever you want to go on it.
Nice detailing on
we're
the land.
We're just gonna try and skip over some stuff. I'm gonna keep the other video up on YouTube. Can't melee that yet. So yeah, I'm gonna keep the other video up, label as one, and then this is just two.
Or I might
just label it as encounter one. Part 1.5. I am hoping to, maybe I should not have recorded, maybe I should have just played privately until I got to the point where I was last. This one has the aesthetics of the magic, the fantasy weapon, but it has the reload of an actual gun. Yeah, I'm just trying to speed right on. So I know where that leads. Can't do that yet.
I put shortcuts around the overworld to help you get around. All you gotta do is a pension.
Just gonna ignore some of these obvious ones. Speed. Very little buff, fuck it.
You're good at that! There's all sorts of goodies in dungeons hidden behind things you can punch. Oh, man, this is the best. I am so glad you guys are here to play games and be friends. It's just been me in this cave with the Glenbows and, like, a mountain of marshmallow cereal for, like, ever.
Have you been lonely?
Because of the amount of that magic damage I'm doing, I'm managing to stay alive by constantly draining my health. But yeah, the two bugs that I...
You can totally flap that thing over and cross it, and then you have permanently opened a new route through the Wonderland! Look at you, baby!
But yeah, the two bugs that I came across in the first video, I've yet to come across again. So I don't know like what prominence they are. I wouldn't be surprised if this game got another update. So soon. Like most games get like a day one update or something like that.
Her coruscating majesty, Queen Buttstallion, has long protected the Wonderlands with the soul magic she imbues into the land itself. It's such a precious wall requires guarding as well, as proven by the terrible events at Dragon Keep. And so, the Queen founded a new walled city from which to oversee her realm. Brighthold, the seat of the Adamant Throne.
One thing I'm quite disappointed is the fact that Tiny Tina is who first back to the age she was in Borderlands 2, which means this game takes place. It's a bit weird. Like the timeline of them leaving the cave is before Borderlands 2, and depending on the ending, it'll raise the question of where was Fret and Valentine during the events. Mind you, we don't even entirely know what exactly they are. All we know is that they're just crashing for a minute. And then I was fucking pissed. That Tina was apparently stupid.
This whole thing is really below my god.
I
Someone pay attention to Max Carryweight.
But yeah, I'm really also enjoying just the amount of actual D&D and like just the references in general. Actually, I don't know what this weapon's crossbow bonus is per thing.
If I'm going down, you're coming with me!
I have limited power to your fingertips, and you're taking hot shots.
Yeah! Your half bones!
So I quickly looked away to the other side. I'm just going to look over here for the things. I do wish they would have. Hold on. If I press X on that, maybe. No, it just unequipped it. Guard of Salvage. Guard of firing, which has higher, so let's set that. I wish there was a better way for me to examine all these items, because it's a little frustrating, like, especially when you get. Especially when you get like a bunch of loot, like you're having to go in through each individual item. We are almost where we were in the actual game, and we're under an hour in. So we're almost there. Arc torn spells, fire beam, magical ring. So hopefully we can recover, like we can get to where we were. But again, a part of me is still thinking like I should have just, you know, did that by myself and then continue on. Oh god. I did not get a lot of sleep last night. Thanks. Goddamn.
Newbie, don't worry. Those Urks people can hear me. It's just us down here. Hey, I know I'm the villain, but I still just wanted to wish you luck on the whole quest thing. Not that you need luck, right? I mean, you're the fate maker.
And that's another thing I'm finding in very amusing. You know, first sell all the useless gear. And this is another thing. Why is it that some of these items don't go away? Yeah, you know, like I'm just like, what the hell? There we go. It's like the marking things doesn't always work. It's just weird. I'm gonna mark that one to be sold. We're gonna save our weapons. Meta-tax will store 2.0 your spell cooldown. Yes! Very much want that. Speed through this.
Before you rise the mighty walls of Great Hook, but you're not the only right. A massive skeleton army is sieging the city! Catapults! Skelly mans! Skelly ships! There's bombs raining down! Skelly ships land on the beach, unloading evil cargo of skelly mans and skelly women!
This whole thing is really below my
challenge! Ah, crap! Oh, bad guys, need more work! That's a bloody detailed map.
Just gonna quickly mark things to sell. Quickly inspection. See if this. Okay, yeah, this is a normal gun. Okay.
Phony pricks a hard time.
Quite the mouth on you, paladin.
Do I bloody look like I've got time for manners lessons? I'm up to my codpiece and I'm dead. I came out of nowhere.
Yeah, that's the Dragon Lord's doing. Just came from robbing his tomb, actually.
The Dragon Lord? Bollocks, we'll have to deal with him later. Right now, we have to break this siege. The undead have catapults lobbing skeletons over the walls. I need you to destroy them. Here, take this C4.
Tina, I know you like explosives, but can you make it more fantasy themed than C4?
Right. Good catch, yeah.
Here, take this, fantasy C4. I'll help the villagers get to safety. Fight through the siege fields and use that fantasy C4 to blow the catapults to kingdom bloody come! Yeah, let's kill these idiots a second time!
This whole thing is really below.
On my first road trip, it's only now do I realize that was Carline. If I'm remembering her name right from Borderlands 2, because like through an Echonet, so through an Echologue, you learn that she was a breeder before she actually became resistance fighter. And that's how it's been like, it's been zero.
Eat skull,
Nimrod! Oh, he's still alive.
That's way too big of a jump. What if we undestroyed that last catapult and threw ourselves over?
Hey! Don't touch any miniatures! Launching yourself with a catapult sounds cool, so I'm gonna let it go this once!
But yeah, I'm also really into some of the name changes they made for guns.
Giving me so many skills, everyone else so few.
Like
those catapults take hundreds of goblin hours to construct. I'm out here creating jobs, you know.
Heads up, we got company. This isn't even fair.
Why is that progress I keep getting? Ah. Yeah, everything's just money and XP. And these weird moon coins, I guess. Do they have gun challenges for the companies? Because I always found like that was a good way of encouraging stuff. Boss, character. As a club bringing a slave for us with a hammer. Keep your Reaper of Bones action skill active for at least 25 seconds. That one would be difficult. As a good born, leech health from your foe using dark magic.
Yeah?
Alright, one sec, folks. And this is why I can't wait to move out. Okay, so yeah, I'm just going to go do this rest of this myself. I can't guarantee not getting getting more distractions and whatnot, because we have a lot of shit going on today. So, this is it's actually one of the main reasons why I haven't been doing the Let's Play series. Because I just can't guarantee not getting any interruptions, like from anyone in my family. Like, it's not just what's going on today, like, it's just in general. Wow, they really took out the manufacturer challenges, it looks like. That is... Okay, there's SMGs. Yeah, they really removed it. So that's a bit disappointing. So now using the... I don't even know if they still have the loyalty system where you would be given items based on your what you've been using. I'm going to end the stream here, folks. I'm going to get this back to where I was during the last stream. I'm not going to be exporting this onto YouTube. But hopefully I'll get some time to do more of the Let's Play series.